Hi folks, my name is Ken Ota. I'm with RV Corral in beautiful Eugene, Oregon. I'd like to take a few moments of your time and show you the 2016. This is a 27 Shockwave. I'm going to start right up here and then work my way around. Starting here, you got the pass-through storage. It's all nice and finished in here, so you got a ton of storage. Got the light inside. And nice thing is, like I said, it's all finished in here. Moving on down around here. As you can see right here, it's got the textured. So this is basically helps against rock chips and road grime. And then it also will have the dual batteries, 12 volt deep cycle that we install after we sell them. And has the bigger dual propane tanks. And this also is a really nice feature, has the tongue jack with the light on it to help you load. And this also is a light up here too to help you load. Then coming on over here, you got a spot to put your black tank hose in here for storage, and then also the access for your storage on the other side. And right in here, got your generator. And this is a 4000, it's a Cummins Onan 4000. It's a gas generator. And then here's where you hook your power up right here. And then that screws on so it won't pop off of there. So it has a threading on there. And then also, moving on down here, you have your black tank flush system. So you can hook your hose up right here and turn the water on when you're emptying your black tank. That way it has sprayers and it'll spray out the black tank so you don't have to stick a wand down in the toilet and deal with all that mess. So everything's easy to get to right here, your black and your gray. Got a spot for your satellite and cable. If you're going to dry camp, you can fill up your tank here. The nice thing is we have like the biggest freshwater tanks in the industry, and you have 160 gallons. That's an option. We always put that option on all these. 160 gallons of fresh water. If you have water connection, which a lot of places do, you can hook your water up here. You have a hot and cold shower right here that you can pull out and hose the dogs off, the kids off, or whatever. Moving on down here, this has got alloy wheels, so it's nice so they don't rust like steel wheels. Also, you have the linkage, so you have the better linkage in here. The leaf springs don't just go up and connect on to the frame mount. There's a link on the end of each one, so it gives you a better suspension. Here's your fuel tank to add for your fuel, and that's got the pump also, so you can fill that up and use it for your generator and use it to fill up your quads or motorcycles or what have you. This is nice because it has the ladder, and this actually folds up against it and put the pin in, so it's up against there. It doesn't won't hit any branches or anything. Also inside there you do have your fuel gauge and everything that's in there with the handle. You have the manual leveling stabilizer jacks, which everybody usually uses cordless drills or impact wrenches to zip them down. In the back here, you have the, you can see it does have LED lights all the way around. You do have the nice big loading lights in the back that are real bright, and those are LEDs. LEDs are use less power, so they'll extend your battery life. Also, this is really nice because you have the built-in locks, so you don't have to put a padlock on here. It's right here, and you can just click it right down. Real nice and easy. These are locked though right now, but moving on down around here, as you can see, it's got a nice big awning, and it's a power awning. It almost goes down the whole length of the coach. Outside speakers, and then you also have LED lights that are inside on the awning. That light strip will light up all the way down. It's really nice at nighttime. And you also have the big light here that you can turn on too. And as you can see, not big things, but you have drain spouts right there and a rain gutter. So you have the water will shoot out away from the coach up there and over there on all four corners and plus on the awning. So moving down here, I'm going to stop real quick, point out This has got the Arctic package, so it's insulated underneath, and it has the vents that go down through the tank area to keep them from freezing up. So that's a really key package there. We'll come on in here, and I'm going to go this way, and we'll start down here in the bedroom area and work our way down. So in here, basically have an RV queen. You have storage on the side here, storage up above, and then you also have a spot to put a TV over here, so there is a spot for plug-in and what have you. Also, you have a spot for charger for your phone, and more storage down below. And then this also, I'll point out real quick, this also is equipped with solar panels, so you can actually help keep your batteries charged up when you're out off the grid. You can monitor it with this right here, and that's your GoPower solar panels. So, and we'll go back through here. And I'm gonna turn you around and go into the bathroom here. Nice big bathroom. You have the other door that comes straight in, so you don't have to come around. You can go use that door to go in the bathroom. Nice big shower. See how tall it is? Plus you have the skylight, so if you have somebody that's real tall, they can get in there and not have to worry about hitting their head. Storage here, you have the vanity mirror, sink, storage down below. And this is a porcelain toilet. As you can see, it's got the sprayers, the water holes on the top. Kind of weird talking about a toilet, but anyway, so that helps it flush good and it's easier to clean. It's a very good toilet, Dometic toilet. Nice big walk-in glass shower, plenty of room in there. So, and we'll head on down here real quick. So stopping right here, you got your connect for your battery. I like that being out where you can remember and see it. So you basically can shut it off and it'll turn all the battery power off. That way you won't run your batteries down if you're off out goofing around riding or snowmobiling or what have you, or fishing. Also, you don't have to jump out in the middle of the night if trips a breaker. Breakers are right here and your fuses. And then that's for your water heater down there. So, or actually, I'm sorry, that's for your heat pads for your tanks. Also, moving down in here, it's got the Dometic. This is a gas and electric. You can put on auto, don't have to worry about it. It'll run off the generator, or if you plug in, it'll run off that. When that shuts off, if you have it on auto, it'll go over to run on gas. Real quick wire here, has a subwoofer down here, has a really nice stereo system. I'll get to that, but thought I'd point it out while we're over here. Storage, all this is a really nice thing because it does have a ton of storage. You have all the drawers here, storage. It's got the big high sink, and then this pulls out so you can spray, and then you have a nice big sink which you can put those over for more counter space if you're cooking. Also, you have the stainless appliances, so you have the microwave, and you do have the oven still, and then you got the three burners, which this folds up out of the way. And this is real nice because you can see all the counter space you have here. Another thing with you know, trailers and toy haulers is a lot of them don't have a lot of counter space. So it's got a ton of counter space, more storage down here, shelving for pots and pans and dishes and food. Also, all along the top here. Now this does have a slide. That's what makes this have a lot more room. So this does have the slide. This folds up out of the way. So you can fold this up out of the way. This does make into like a hide-a-bed, or not, basically they call it a jackknife bed this folds into. You can put the table here. And then back here, this has the two power bunks. And then this does fold up into a seat, so you can actually sit and have this a big seating area once you put this down. You also have, back here, you have the netting for, you can put this down and have it open so you can get some ventilation through, but the mosquitoes won't get in. Or you can close it down and have it solid but clear so you can actually look outside and have this out open. More storage all along here. And also looking right here, this does have, so you can set this down and make it into a patio. More storage up here. This is all touchscreen for your DVD, CD player. It runs off of Bluetooth, so you can just play music off your phone, what have you. So it's a really nice system. Got your flat screen TV that pulls out right here. When I'm out and about, I don't watch a whole lot of TV, but want to be out playing. Storage above, down below. Now these two chairs, you can move them up here and then remove this table. So you have all this storage area for a quad or a Razor or what have you. So also you have air conditioning. It's ducted throughout the coach. You have speakers and again, all LED lights, new for 16. Tons of tie downs throughout the coach also for tying down your fun toys. And I'm sure I'm probably missing a lot more here, but we only have so much time. So please give me a call. My name's Ken, again, really easy, K-E-N. I'd really appreciate if you asked for me. And my cell number is 541-870-6535. Call me anytime. No questions, a silly question, just call me. I'm available anytime. You can reach me on my office number also, which is 541-689-9204. Thanks again for viewing my video. Please contact me. Love to talk to you. Have a great day.